Here's a bucket marked finished petrified wood. Let's open it up and see what's in it. Okay, here we have me playing around. I cut a cube from a piece of agate that is not very good to look at. I threw it in the tumbler for a little while, rounded off the corners. But it's from Clear Creek. That was self-collected. Then we have a piece of Congleton Hollow limb cast, followed by a piece of black skin India agate, although it's not very black. A small piece of Bruno Jasper. Another India agate. Got some nice banding in there. A chunk of Saddle Mountain petrified wood. A limb cast from Blue Forest in Wyoming. Another piece of pink limb cast from Congleton Hollow. Just a fortification nodule, don't recall the location. Another piece of limb cast from Congleton Hollow. I think these two actually go together. Looks like they do. This is a piece of Saddle Mountain wood. Of bog wood. That's why it doesn't have much in the way of wood grain. I think that is also from Saddle Mountain. Not sure the location of this one. Pretty dark. Another piece of limb cast from Saddle Mountain. Same thing, limb cast from Saddle Mountain, and a whole series of them. These are all from Saddle Mountain. This one's been tumbled slightly. Now here I decided to do lengthwise. Here. Some more petrified wood. I believe this is from Hampton Butte. Another piece of Hampton Butte petrified wood. This is a jasper instead of agate. Nice colorful piece of Saddle Mountain. I don't think this is Saddle Mountain. It might be Hubbard Basin, but I'm not positive. This is Hampton Butte. You can see these two go together. Some Thundereggs. These have been on display in a museum, which is why I have little cards about them. And these five pieces are from Australia. There's a little hole nodule. It's got some tiny little crystals in there. Some of these were self-collected. I did manage to go there. This one has a nice crystal pocket in there. I think this is one that I dug up. Same with this one. Unfortunately, these things formed in limestone and a lot of them developed cracks. Another part of a nodule. With a small pocket in it. There's a broken chunk of a nodule. When they sit out in the sun, they bleach out to a kind of a milky white. See, here's the white, but then as soon as you cut into it, you get into the other colors. Lots of reds and yellows. There's some botryoidal. Or botryoidal, I don't know how to pronounce that. I've heard it multiple ways. The guys that took me out digging told me that if I managed to cut a clean 30 by 40 cabochon out of this material that had no fractures in it, that it'd be worth about $125. Cut a few calves. but it is hard to find good material that isn't all fractured up. And that'll do it for this one. Thank you.